One of the leading human rights issues of our time is the treatment of LGBTQI people around the world. You know this better than I do. In many countries, they face violence, harassment, stigma, rejection. They aren't protected equally by laws. In fact, they're often targeted and scapegoated by those who make and enforce the laws. A few days after taking office, President Biden signed a memorandum instructing all U.S. agencies engaged in diplomacy and development to promote and protect the human rights of LGBTQI people around the world.
More than 18,000 volunteers, many of them young people from Germany, the United States, and other countries, have joined the Every Name Counts project. They have transcribed more than 3.6 million handwritten documents with the names of people victimized or murdered by the Nazis. In recent years, we have seen anti-Semitic tropes and rhetoric spread unchecked via social media and the internet. And we have seen concerted efforts to try to cast doubt on the very facts of the Holocaust. Authoritarian actors always try to gain power by sowing division, bigotry, and hatred, and by spreading misinformation and lies. It is up to all of us to resist those forces.
We meet at a time when transgender and gender diverse people have never been more visible as public intellectuals and elected officials, entrepreneurs and researchers, artists and scientists, and simply as members of our communities. We're advancing LGBTQI rights worldwide as part of our foreign policy at the direction of President Biden. As the president has made clear, and I quote, "Everyone is entitled to dignity and equality, no matter who they are, whom they love, or how they identify. And we will continue to engage with allies and partners to advance the human rights of LGBTQI people here at home and in all corners of the world." We share the goal of a sovereign, stable, unified, secure Libya, free from foreign interference. It's what the people of Libya deserve. It's critical to regional security as well. For that to happen, national elections need to go forward in December, and that means urgent agreement is needed on constitutional and legal issues that would undergird those elections. By launching the U.S. Germany Dialogue on the Holocaust, we are helping to ensure that current and future generations learn about the Holocaust and also learn from it. Together, we honor those who were killed. They were not indistinct numbers, even if a number is seared in the minds of many of us.
People don't feel like they're being heard, that they're seen, and that people are taking care of them. And sometimes they express this issue, unfortunately, through hatred and even through violence. Those of your generation are much more tolerant than my generation. So you need to speak out to say what is acceptable and what is not. And in a democracy, we need to listen to you.
many of our embassies and consulates have displayed the pride and progress flags overseas, today is the first time a flag recognizing the LGBTQI plus community will fly over State Department headquarters. We raise the progress flag today as a signal to people everywhere that the United States is firmly committed to doing that work and to fighting for LGBTQI plus people at home and everywhere.